subject.
十二个字，中文十二个字。
12 words in Chinese.
立足本位，更新突破，迈向万里。
Stand firm, be renewed, go to the nations.
我是用一个人物来做骨干。
I'm using a person as the foundation of today's sermon.
这个因为经文很多，我就选读几章就好了啊。
Because the passage is quite long, so I'm going to pick a few verses.
所以呢，我就先读，我们一同来读这个使徒行传第六章。
So let's read Acts chapter 6.
那么就请各位拿英文圣经的，麻烦各位啊来念你的英文圣经。
So for those who read English, let's go to Acts chapter 6, verses 3 to 7.
读中文的一起来念，预备，请。所以弟兄们，当从你们中间选出四个有好名声、被圣灵充满、智慧充足的人，我就派他们管理这事。但我们要专心祈祷、传道为事。大众都喜悦这话，就拣选了史提凡，是大有信心、圣灵充满的人；又拣选腓力、伯罗哥罗、尼加罗、提门、巴米拿，并进犹太教的安提亚人尼哥拉。好，我们读到这里，然后呢，再读，第八章。
Let's go to Acts chapter 8.
第四节。到第六节
verses 4 to 6.
那是分散的人往各处去传道，腓力下撒玛利亚城去宣扬基督，众人听见了，又看见腓力所行的神迹，就同心合意的听从他的话。好，那么我们来第八章二十六节。
Alright, so now Acts chapter 8 26 to 40.
有主的一个使者对腓力说，起来向南走，往那从耶路撒冷下加沙的路上去，那路就是旷野。腓力就起来，使人不料有一个伊索庇亚，是个大有大权的太监，在伊索庇亚女王甘大基的手下总管银库。他上耶路撒冷敬拜去，现在回来，在车上坐着念先知以赛亚的书。好，我们读到这里。这段圣经大家都比较熟的哈。
We're somewhat familiar with this passage.
讲到这个腓力，腓力是本来在耶路撒冷做执事的。
Talking about Philip, initially he was in Jerusalem as a deacon.
那但是他的人生有三个很大的这个的 stage, 三个阶段。
But there are three stages in his life.
每一个的阶段呢，都是因为他做了一个很重要、很重要、很重要的决定。
In each stage is because he made certain important decisions.
那么几年前呢，我就在 Costco 看到一本书。
A few years ago, I saw this book in Costco.
就是George Bush 写的啊。
Written by President George W. Bush.
你知道美国总统做完总统之后一定写书的。
So you know how presidents write books after they're done with their terms.
那么这本书的名字叫做 Decision Point, 决定的时刻。
So the name of the book is called Decision Point.
那个时候很贵，25块。
Used to be $25.
我舍不得买。
I didn't want to spend the money.
我等了三年。
I waited 3 years.
在 Amazon.com 3.5。
So I got it for $3.50 off Amazon.
Use one, 没关系，都很好啊。
Still in good condition.
那么这本书呢，我不是从头读到尾没有啊。
I didn't read a book from front to the back.
但是我知道说这本书呢，说到这个 George W. Bush, 他做了人生几个重要重要的决定。
But this book talks about some of the most important decisions George W. Bush did.
包括了他接受耶稣基督做他个人救主。
Including receiving Christ as his personal savior.
包括了他要做这个州长。
And becoming a governor.
然后要决定要做选总统等等。
And to run for the president.
他的决定影响他的家庭。
His decisions changed and affected his family.
也影响美国。
And affected the entire nation.
也影响到全世界。
And the world.
所以我们今天每一个决定。
So today, every single decision we make.
都有很大的影响。
Has a lot of impact.
第一件的事情啊。
The first thing.
这个的腓力呢，他有上他有人生三个重要的阶段。
There are three important stages in Philip's life.
第一个，他做执事。
First one, he was a deacon.
当然了，你说，哎呀，到底是使徒选他出来的
啊。So you may be thinking, okay, the apostles picked him.
但是他自己也要决定接受这个的推选，他才能够成为执事。
But I think that he also had to accept the nomination to become a deacon.
所以他第一个，他决定做执事。
So the first one, he made a decision to become a deacon.
所以呢，他住在耶路撒冷。
So he lived in Jerusalem.
那么服侍那个地方的教会。
Serving the church over there.
他被推选为七位执事之一。
He was chosen to be one of the seven deacons.
他有好名声，有智慧充足，还圣灵充满。
Good reputation, full of the spirit and wisdom.
很多时候我们在教会。
A lot of times in church.
就讲到管理饭食哈。
We talk about serving tables.
你知道吗？管理饭食就是打菜的，烧饭的啊。
You know, the ones helping out in the kitchen, cooking.
应该有什么的条件呢？
What are some of the requirements?
有好名声。
Good reputation.
智慧充足。
Full of wisdom,
还要圣灵充满才可以打饭
and be full of the Spirit to be able to serve tables.
很多时候我们以为，哎呀，这个简单的事，哎，随便，你刚信主，你去做，你去做，你去做。
So oftentimes we go like this, whatever, just go ahead and do it.
不是要圣灵充满
No, you got to be full of the Spirit.
还要好名声
and of good reputation.
这个是他做执事的阶段
So this is the stage when he was a deacon.
那么第二个阶段呢
And the second stage,
因为耶路撒冷大遭逼迫了。
Because Christians were persecuted in Jerusalem.
那么住在耶路撒冷的信徒呢，都四处的那个的离开，就四处的迁离了。
The believers in Jerusalem started going off and going out to different places.
这个腓尼呢去了撒玛利亚城。
So Philip went to Samaria.
在大逼迫之后呢，移居到撒玛利亚城。
So he moved over there after a persecution.
他不再做执事了。
He wasn't a deacon anymore.
他成为布道家。
He became an evangelist.
他甚至能够行神迹。
He started performing miracles.
很多人信主。
Leading a lot of people to Christ.
圣经告诉我们说，整个撒玛利亚城都高兴起来了。
So the Bible tells us the entire Samaria was really excited.
非常的快乐。
Extremely happy.
因为很多人信主。
Because a lot of people started believing in the Lord.
做非常非常的有果效。
Because his work was very effective.
他在耶路撒冷的时候。
In Jerusalem.
他是做管理饭食的。
He was serving tables.
但是在那个撒玛利亚城呢，他做了一个布道家。
But in Samaria, he was actually an evangelist.
大批的带领大批的人信耶稣。
Leading tons and tons of people to the Lord.
所以呢，侍奉呢由行政管理变为了福音布道。
So he went from doing admin work to becoming evangelist.
第三件事情。
The third stage.
在撒玛利亚城的时候，他蒙到神的呼召。
He was actually called by the Lord when he was in Samaria.
受到主的使者的差遣，离开撒玛利亚城。
He was commissioned to leave Samaria.
各位，他不是说，哎呀，这个工作已经没有什么果效了，哎呀，都没人信主，哎呀，我离开吧，不是这样子的。
He wasn't thinking, okay, my work is not as effective anymore, so let's leave.
是非常成功的时候。
It was actually when it was at its peak, it was very successful.
神的声音说，要离开撒玛利亚城，到旷野去。
God told him, leave this place and go to the desert place.
他去的时候，
when he left,
还不知道有什么事情发生。
He didn't know what was going on, actually.
他先离开，
he left first.
他先去，
he went.
才知道神所为他预备的机会。
And then he understood what God's plan was.
很多时候我们希望说，哎呀，神啊，你为我预备这机会，好吧，我就去吧。
A lot of times we ask God, okay, prepare something for me, and then I'll go.
他没有，好像亚伯拉罕一样。
He wasn't like this. He wasn't like Abraham.
他离开那个老家的时候，
when he left this house,
还不知道要去什么地方。
He didn't know where he was headed.
但神吩咐他说，你要离开本地本族父家。
But God said you have to leave your house, your family.
我记得这个 Francis Chan.
Francis Chan.
他岂不是在北这个？洛杉矶北边有一个教会吗？
He has a church in LA.
那么他的教会有4500人。
There are 4,500 people in his church.
那么他们开执事会的时候
，When they had their deacon elder meetings.
那时的执事告诉 Francis Chan.
The deacons told Francis.
他说很多的这个 visitor 访客来教会的时候
，When visitors come visit our church.
进到礼拜堂。
When they come into the sanctuary,
就问说，今天是不是 Francis Chan 讲道？
They ask, is Francis Chan speaking today?
他们有时候哦，Francis 今天不在。
Sometimes they say, oh, Francis not here.
那些访客就离开走了。
And the visitors will leave.
所以呢，那个 Francis Chan， 哎呀，他们来是要听我讲道。
So Francis Chan was like, oh wow, they came here to listen to me.
他说，这个时候是我应该离开教会的时候。
And this is actually when I have to leave the church.
因为这些人不是来看耶稣的，来看我的。
Because they're not here to see Jesus, but to see me.
所以就在那个时候，他因为听见这句话，他就离开教会。
So after hearing this, he decided to leave the church.
现在教会上凡事做什么呢？
So right now he's in San Francisco.
住在一个比较普通的地方，做那个个人布道，敲门啊。一家一户的传福音。
So he's actually doing individual family ministries, knocking on the doors of people to spread the gospel.
他不是越做呢就越红啊。
He wasn't trying to become popular. When he was at the peak of his career, he changed his direction of his ministry, just like Philip. Leaving Samaria to go into the desert place. We know God has his own purpose when he changes our course.
那么神第一方面，神是用耶路撒冷的地方教会来操练这个的啊，操练这个腓力。
So first, God used the church in Jerusalem to train Philip.
就用这个管理饭食哈，来训练他有一个仆人的心。
To train him to become a servant by serving tables.
我们说 spiritual formation 灵命塑造。
When you talk about spiritual formation,
第一件事情要做的就是仆人的心的塑造，就servant heart formation.
The first thing that we have to know is to have the servant heart formation.
第一件事情我们看见是你要先做仆人，才能够做仆人的工作。
We need to be a servant before we can do what a servant does.
你先做一个仆人，然后才要做仆人的工作。
We have to be a servant first before we can do what a servant does. 你要真的用心去做，
不是要装给人看。哎，你看我多谦卑，不是这样子。
You gotta do it willingly and not pretending.
你要甘心的勉强自己，也要勉强的要勉强自己来去甘心。
You have to willingly force yourself to be willing.
各位弟兄姐妹
，brothers and sisters，
你知道一件事情
？There's one thing.
我们在教会的当中。
When we're in church,
特别做领袖的,
especially once leading Bible study,
不是, 做领袖, 做 leader,
being church, leaders, being church leaders,
我们首先要做仆人, 才能够做仆人领袖, servant leader.
We have to be servants first before we can become servant leaders.
不然的话呢, 我们不是 church leader, 我们是 church boss.
Otherwise, we wouldn't be church leaders, we'll be church bosses.
不是教会领袖, 只是变成教会老板。
We want to be leaders in the church, but be bosses of the church.
你问我说教会老板跟教会教会领袖有什么分别
？And you ask me the difference between the church's boss and church's.
教会领袖是有仆人的心。
A leader actually has a servant heart.
教会老板呢只有这个管人的心。
Boss only has the heart to manage people.
做官的心。
To be leaders or to be in the office.
这个不是圣经里面讲的。
It's not from the Bible.
你知道以利沙跟以利亚。
You know, Elisha and Elijah.
你知道以利亚是以利沙的以利沙的先老师。
You know, Elisha was the Elijah was the teacher of Elijah.
当以利亚离开之前
，When Elijah left,
他就问以利沙。
He asked Elisha.
上帝快要接我走了。
God is about to take me away.
你要什么
？What do you want?
那么以利沙就说什么
？And then Elisha said.
他说愿感动你的灵，加倍的来感动我。
I pray that spirit that touches you also touch me even more.
那么我们发现这个以利圣经给我们圣经记载。
The Bible says.
以利亚呢，总共呢行了七个神迹。
Elijah performed 7 miracles.
以利沙呢就行了，这是圣经记载14个神迹，刚刚是两倍。
It is recorded that Elisha actually had 14 miracles recorded in the Bible. It's more than what his Elisha
did.
But before Elisha became a great prophet, he was actually helping Elijah wash his hands and pour water.
神就是用这个以利亚来训练以利沙有一个仆人的心。
He actually trained him. God trained him to become a servant with a servant heart. To become a true servant. So that he could become a good prophet. Today, everybody wants to be a great prophet. We don't want to be humble servants. It's actually two sides of the same coin, being a great leader and a prophet, and also a servant, connected. Great prophet, humble servant, same thing.
这种人才是上帝所使能够使用的人。
This is the kind of people that God wants to use.
很有恩赐
blessed with gifts,
很有口才
with able to speak.
讲话呢就是噼里呱啦的哦，这个不是神的，这个要神的要的仆人。
So by speaking a lot doesn't mean that God wants to use you.
两遍 伟大的先知跟谦卑的仆人连在一起。
Great prophets and humble servants connected as one.
我们教会有一位弟兄过世了哈。
There was a brother in my church.
我们叫他 Uncle Tom.
His name was Uncle Tom.
我们开了个分堂。
We actually the church planting.
他住在我们分堂附近呢，所以他去了个分堂。
So he lived very close by to the satellite church.
那么他就我们就借用美国教会。
So we were using this American church.
那个美国教会呢很特别，每一次聚会都要我们把椅子呢从二楼搬到楼下，聚会完又从楼下搬回楼上。
So the church was actually very special. Every single week, they asked that helpers move all the chairs from the second floor to the first floor, and after they're done, move them back.
Uncle Tom 来我们教会的时候已经八十几岁，已经八十几岁了。
When Uncle Tom came to our church, he was already 80 something years old.
他呢第一个到教会。
He was the first one to come to this church.
从楼上呢拉四张椅子就搬下来。
So he would bring all the chairs from the second floor to the first.
聚会完以后呢，就把椅子都搬回上去。
After they were done with the service, he would bring them all back up to the second floor.
这个 Uncle Tom 他是个科学家 scientist.
He was a scientist.
他有份发明彩色电视。Color TV. 他有 patent.
Okay.
Inventor.
So he invented and he had patents for color TV.
当然不是说他。全部他是他有一个 pattern 在彩色电视的里面。
He had a pattern in color TV.
所以他是个科学家。
So he was a scientist.
大有学问。
Very knowledgeable.
八十几岁。
80 some years old.
还搬来搬去，搬来搬去。
Still carrying all those chairs.
那么人家问他说。
So people asked him.
说你在教会做什么呢
？What do you do at church?
他就会很荣耀的说 ，I am the chairman of the church.
So he will be proudly saying to people, I'm the chairman of the church.
Chairman.
Chairman.
我是搬椅子的
I'm the one who carries all the chairs.
哎呀，他讲的时候，我就哎呀，这个就是教会领袖的写照。
He said, "Wow, this is a servant in the church."
又是又学问，大有学问。
Very knowledgeable, very reputable.
但是同时也做仆人的工作。
But at the same time, he was a pure servant.
这个叫做教会领袖。
This is a church leader.
徐长老，你是大会主席吗
？Elder Joe, you are the chairperson of our church.
各位，千万不要叫他搬椅子哈。我看他年纪都蛮大的。
Don't make him carry chairs, please.
我看他起码都有45岁啊。
He's probably at least 45 years old.
No, 这就是我们自愿的。
So this is voluntary.
不是人家叫我们的。
Not because we're forced to.
这个Uncle Tom 90岁的时候。
When Uncle Tom was in his 90s,
他还去接送那些小孩来去教会，因为是小留学生过来。
He was actually driving a lot of new immigrant kids.
九十岁去接那个十九岁的过来做礼拜。
90-some-year-old driving a 19-year-old to church.
有一次看到一半的过来，他在红绿灯就睡着了。
One time he fell asleep at a light.
那个小朋友以后不敢坐他的车。
So the kid was saying, "No, I'm not going to sit in your car anymore."
他做到这个地步才不坐，你知道吗
？That's when he stopped driving.
有一次
one time,
他每天早上都祷告。
Every morning he would pray.
长时间的祷告。
Pray for an extensive amount of
time. 祷告完之后呢，才吃饭。
And he would then eat.
那么有一次，他的太太说，哎 ，Tom 下来吃饭了，这样子。
One time his wife asked him, "Okay, it's time for breakfast."
他在那边祷告。
He was praying.
啊，祷告都很陶醉。
Like he was really enjoying it.
那么太太就说，哎，起来吃饭了。
And his wife told him, "Time to eat."
就咬他几下。
And then she was.Moving him,
已经给主接去了
and he was taken away.
他在祷告当中离开世界
He passed away while praying.
还不错吧
It was pretty good, huh?
阿们，耶稣就在前面
Jesus was right there.
多好呢
Wasn't it wonderful?
在祷告当中给主接去
Taken away while you're praying.
好过你打牌的时候给主接去
It's better than when you're playing poker.
呼，你知道这样子。太高兴了
，so happy，
心脏病发
，having a heart attack，
就死在这个麻将牌桌上面了。
died on the poker table. When you see God，
耶稣里面还有个麻将呢。
you still have some poker cards.
耶稣说：“你后面那是什么？不好意思。
”What you got in the back？
是麻将这样子。
No， sorry。
多不好意思了。
It will be pretty embarrassing.
弟兄姐妹
，brothers and sisters，
这是 Uncle Tom。
This is Uncle Tom。
这是我们今天很多弟兄姐妹。
A lot of brothers and sisters today, especially ones serving in the church for a while, sometimes we complain. Why is it always me carrying the chairs? Why is it always me serving tables?
管卫生
啊。Why am I always doing the sanitary tasks?
哎呀，我真是希望不需要做了，我希望享福。
Oh, I don't want to do this. I want to relax and chill.
哎，什么都不需要做。
I don't want to do anything.
啊，这是我们的盼望，这是有福的人生。
This is our hope.
哎，不再服侍人。
The dream life. No more serving.
让人家来服侍我多好呢。
Let others serve me. Wouldn't that be so nice?
以前呢，去韩国旅行的时候有一个项目啊。
There's this.
有一个节目。
Oh, there's this event when you go to Korea.
去 Korea 的，去旅游的时候。
When you tour Korea, when you travel to Korea.
有些旅行团呢有一个节目啊。
There's this event in these tours.
啊，就说要你做皇帝了。
Oh, for you to become an emperor of Korea.
就享受一下。
To enjoy your life.
以前的韩国皇帝是怎么吃饭的
？How the emperors ate.
动的手啊，动也不需要动。
They don't have to move their hands.
啊，左边是人参鸡。
That's how they eat chicken.
右边的就是烤牛肉
and beef.
上面是一串的葡萄掉下来
and then grapes.
所以呢，动也不动，坐在那边
They didn't have to move.
所以每一个人都这样子享受一下，做皇帝是这样子做。
So everybody kind of enjoyed how an emperor looked.
你就很高兴啊。
So you'd be very happy.
哎呀，主啊，我以前太辛苦了，在教会做这个，在家里面也做这个，太辛苦了，我要做皇帝。
I was working so hard at church in the family. Now I want to be the emperor. I don't have to move my hands.
那边牛肉上面葡萄。那么你就祷告。
So you start praying.
主啊，我真的觉得这个是有福的生活。
Oh, I really think this is a blessed life.
我服侍人服侍到现在那一打八年级还做事情。
I serve people for such a long time.
教会还做这个还做那个。
Serving so many areas in the church.
搬那个搬这个。
Moving things here and there.
太辛苦了。
So much work.
我要享福一下。
I would love to enjoy my life.
主啊，你帮助我，给我个这个福气啊。
Please help me have this kind of life.
你就祷告主啊，我要做韩国皇帝。
I want to be a Korean emperor.
两个礼拜之后。
Two weeks later.
神垂听你的祷告。
And God listened to your prayer.
你中风了。
You get a stroke.
动也不能动。
And you can't move.
左边是药水。
So you started taking medicine.
这边就是麦片。
Oatmeal.
上面掉下来点滴。
Yeah, IV.
各位，这个不就有福啊？
This is not a blessed life.
这个就有病。
This is being sick.
所以弟兄姐妹，你想想看。
So think about it.
我今天已经六十几岁，譬如说啊。
Let's say I'm 60 some years old.
I'm 61, alright.
I'm 61 years old.
我说我已经七十几岁了。
Say I'm 70.
哎呀，我今天还在能够。做这个事情，做那个事情。
I'm still doing this and that.
各位，这个是搬这个搬这个多好，这个是有福气
的。This is actually a blessed life.
你喜欢搬东西呢，还是给人搬呢？
Do you prefer to be moving things or be moved by others? What do you say?
谁是有福的呢？
Who is more blessed?
我七十几岁能够做那么多事情，岂不是有福气吗？
70 years old, I can still do so many things.
为什么你觉得不好呢？
Why do you think it's bad?
为什么你喜欢给人搬来搬去呢？
Why would I want to be moved by other people?
弟兄姐妹，这是我们操练做仆人的心啊。
We got to train ourselves to have the servant heart this way.
不但只这样子啊。
Not only this.
你要做一不但只是做这个仆人的心，你要学习做卑微的工作。
Not only having a servant heart, you got to do the lowly jobs.
弟兄姐妹，在教会里面
，in the church，
保罗责备哥林多的弟兄姐妹。
Paul kind of talked to the church of Corinth，
责备他们。这个在这个哥林多前书第十一章
，he reprimanded them in First Corinthians chapter 10。
责备他们不按理赐主的圣餐，你记得吗
？Saying that they weren't taking the communion properly.
保罗不是说，哎呀，你们领圣餐的时候搞错了，应该呢先是饼，然后呢后是杯，然后先祷告后唱诗。
He didn't say that. Okay, the order is incorrect. You have to take the bread and the wine, or to sing or pray first.
也不是说，哎呀，圣餐呢应该是每个礼拜领的，不是每个月领的。
He wasn't saying that you should take the communion every week.
各位，保罗不是教他们怎么样领受圣餐。
Paul wasn't telling them how to take communion.
保罗呢是责备他们不忘，就是忘记了圣餐的意义。
He reprimanded them for not remembering the purpose of having communion.
因为哥林多教会有两批人，一批是有钱的，一批是普通的。
Because there are two groups of people in the church of Corinth. One very rich, one very poor.
一到教会呢，
When they came to the church,
吃饭的时候呢，有钱的就在一堆，
the rich ones will be eating together, and the poor ones will be eating together.
使到那些没有钱的显出他们的好像不好意思的状态。
So making the poor ones a little embarrassed.
然后呢，他们啊、哦，吃完晚餐了，我们吃圣餐了，这样子。
So after they were done, they were like, okay, time to eat.
在圣餐的时候呢，说哎呀，我们是兄弟姐妹，我们是一个饼一个杯。
When they're taking communion, they will be saying, okay, yeah, we're all brothers and bread and And Paul said, no, this is wrong. There's no high and low in the church. No loyalties, and there are no inferior people. Like they're not important. Everything in the church is important. So how do we train ourselves to do the lowly job? We got to wash each other's feet. Because there are many jobs and roles in the church. One time I noticed one thing accidentally. There's a nursery class with three teachers.
那么三个老师呢，有都是博士。
They were actually all PhDs.
有一个是工程博士。
One of them was an engineering PhD.
然后呢，他奉献再拿一个神学博士。
And then he actually got an MD. PhD in.
现在呢，在神学院叫副教务主任。在神学院做 vice dean.
Oh, vice dean in the seminary.
但是他平常礼拜天在教会服侍的是三岁四岁的。
But then at church, he was actually serving in the nursery for a little kids of 3 years old.
我们教会有位一位大老板。
There is a big boss, CEO.
开很大工厂。
With a big factory in.
退休之后。
After he retired.
他做什么呢
？What did he do?
当然他做其他，他有去开大的 church van。每个礼拜去接老人家来教会。
So actually, he will be driving the church van to drive elderly to the church.
我记得二十年前。
I remember 20 years ago.
我在师大旁边一个教会讲道。
I went to this school in Taiwan.
我就看见这个教会呢没有牧师哈。
I saw that this church that attended did not have a pastor.
另外，我也发现这个教会很特别，每一个家具、每一张椅子都有一个人的名字贴在上面。
And I noticed something different. Every piece of furniture had a name on it.
我以为是那个人捐给教会的。
I thought it was the person who donated the furniture to the church.
原来不是。
But it wasn't that.
原来就是说，这个，比如说你的名字在这个讲台，就说你这个礼拜呢负责这个讲台的清洁。
Oh, so it's actually if your name is on this podium, then you're responsible for cleaning it this week.
老师，你的名字在钢琴呢，那个钢琴的清洁为你负责。
If your name is on the piano, that means you have to clean it.
你的名字可能在马桶上面。
It could be on the toilet.
你就是要负责神家的马桶，由你来负责。
And that means God wants you to clean the toilet.
我觉得也很好。
I thought that was very good.
我们就操练这个卑微的工作。
To train ourselves to do a lowly jobs.
第三方面。
The third point.
什么叫做仆人领袖呢
？What is a servant leader?
仆人领袖不是说哎我做卑微的工作。
It's not about just doing the lowly jobs.
这个仆人的心。
Having a servant.
这个仆人心有另外一个的表达。
There's another way to show this.
就是你能够接纳也能够服侍不同背景的人。
That you can actually accept and serve those who are different from you.
那么教会中呢，其实有不同背景的犹太人呢。
There are different types of Jews with different backgrounds in the church.
其实我们教会里面讲中文的人哈。
Even in our church, there are people speaking Chinese.
特别在北美洲。
In Northern America.
我们就发现所有的教会都是来自不同背景的人。
People in these churches are from different backgrounds.
甚至我看看我教会的英文堂。
If I look at the EM ministry in my church,
我们的英文堂的牧师也是韩国人。
The EM pastor is also Korean.
我们下面有非洲人。
There's also African Americans.
有菲律宾人。
Filipinos.
有日本，什么人都有。总共有16个国家。
There are different people.
都在我们的英文，都在我们的英文堂。
All in our EM.
那么中文堂也是不同的背景。
Mandarin congregation is also of different backgrounds.
所以有不同的人来到我们的教会当。
Different people come to our church.
不同的背景
different backgrounds.
不同的背景有不同的个性
It also means that they have different personalities.
有些人很古老的
Some are pretty old-fashioned.
我们说很古老的人哈。那么有些人呢，就是很古怪的
Some are a little
很古板的
old-fashioned.
差不多了，这样子啊。有些人就很灵巧的。
Some are very clever.
很灵敏的啊。
Or
有些人就是很精啊，这样的很精，很精，很精。
Some are really sharp.
很精打细算，哇，算的很厉害哦。
Oh, they,
一分一毫都不放过你的。有些人是精益求精，精益求精，就是。要求呢，精益求精的，就是那个 perfectionist， 那个完美主义。
Yeah, and some are perfectionists.
什么叫做完美主义呢？
What does it mean to be a perfectionist?
一点不美，完全不美。
If one thing is not good, then nothing is good.
这个是完，这个就是这种的精啊。
Yeah, this is the kind of people we also have.
那么还有一些呢，就是奇奇怪怪的。
Some are really, really weird.
穿衣服也怪怪。
Their outfit is different.
讲话也怪怪。
The way they speak is unique.
脾气也怪怪。
And their personality and temperament, everything is
different. 都是怪人啊。所以有古老的，有这个灵敏的，有精的，有怪的，合起来就是古灵精怪，都在教会里面了。
So now you have basically different kinds of people.
只是，但是都他们都得救了。
But everybody's saved.
对不起。正如我们昨天所说的，都在方舟的里面。
Just like we talked about yesterday, everybody's in the ark.
所以我们要愿意意味思考，才是一个真的仆人。
So we gotta sit in each other's shoes so that we can be true servants.
啊，就是说，你不是永远以自己做中心来去想别人。
Don't always think from your own perspective for others.
来尝试站在别人的那个思考里面来去想事情、看事情。
You gotta stand in other people's shoes to think to think in their perspectives.
教会就好像方舟一样。
The church is also like the ark.
人人都有不同的动物个性。
Everybody is like an animal with their own personalities.
我听过一个故事。
I heard this story once.
一对男女就结婚了。
There's this couple who got married.
那么这个女的就嫁进这个男家的门，嫁进去到他们的家住了。
So the wife moved into the husband's house.
但是呢，他家里面那只狗呢，每一次看到那个新的女主人进来的时候呢，都狂叫狂吠啊。
But then the husband had this dog who would always be barking at the wife.
那个 wife 就很忍耐。
The wife was trying to be patient.
这狗一直骂她，就吠她的时候。
Dog was always barking at her.
她就说，这是第一次哦，这样子。
She would say, okay, that's your first warning.
过几天之后。
A few days later.
一进门。
When she walked in.
又大叫。
The dog started barking again.
那个太太很温柔说，这是第二次哦，这样子。
So she said gently, "Oh, this is the second time."
哦，这样子。
哦，
第三次。
The third time.
进来的时候。
When she walked in.
又吠的几乎要咬她。
Man, the dog started barking and almost started to bite her.
她就很温柔的跑到厨房。
She gently went to the kitchen.
拿一把刀出来，把那个狗宰了。
So she. Found a knife and killed the dog.
那个老公回来，那狗在哪里呢？
So the husband said, well, "Where's the dog?"
他说，我已经宰了。
Oh, I killed it.
哇，那个老公受不了啊。
The husband couldn't stand it anymore.
你怎么可以这样子呢？
How could you have done this?
因为他跟你不熟嘛。
Just because you didn't know the dog?
这样子来吠是很自然的事情。
Of course, it's normal for the dog to be barking at you.
你给他空间嘛。
Give the dog some room.
给他时间啊。
Just some more time.
你怎么可以这样子做呢？
How could you have done this?
难怪人说最毒妇人心啊。
That's why people say like the most evil are some women.
你怎么宰我的宠物呢？
It's just a pet.
那个太太就安静。
The wife said quietly and said,
这是第一次。
This is the first time.
你再讲三次我就把你宰了。
Three more times and you're dead.
我要你与狗同归于尽啊！
You'll be like the dog.
有时候真是需要忍耐。
Sometimes we gotta be patient.
在教会当中，就不能说我宰了你。
In the church, we can't just say.
你是不是有些人吠你、吵你已经不止三次了？
Some people could be barking at you for more than three times.
但是你不能说我宰你啊，不行。
You can't say, "Oh, I'm gonna."
我记得有一次，在教会当中，有些教会的
church.
英文堂。
In our EM。
这个英文堂结束之后。
After the service was over。
一位老外了，美国人的老先生。
This older American gentleman。
那么气冲冲的从崇拜会里面出来。
He was very angry when he walked out。
就一直在 lobby 大声叫。
He started shouting in the lobby。
Who's the pastor? Who's the pastor? 这样子。牧师在哪里？
牧师在哪里？
那因为我的英文牧师不知道跑哪里去了，找不到他。
Because we couldn't find the EM pastor at the time.
其中一个会友就说：“说牧师，这是我们的牧师，这是我牧师这样。”
So one person was pointing at Pastor Lam. Oh, this is our pastor.
这位弟兄我到现在还不能原谅他。
So I still can't forgive this guy until this day.
他这个老先生怎么说呢？
This older gentleman said.
他说。传统圣诗有什么问题 ？What's wrong with the traditional hymns？ 哇，非常厉害，让我没有唱了。
Yeah, so what's wrong with the traditional hymns？
因为刚才他崇拜的时候呢，一首歌他都不会唱，好像今天一样。
He didn't understand because he didn't know any of the songs. He wanted to sing hymns.
他就待不住了。
He couldn't stay there.
他很辛苦了。
It was really tough for him.
他说：“怎么可以你们这样子不唱传统圣诗，还算是教会吗
？”How is it possible that you are not singing hymns? How can you call yourself a church?
我就安慰他说：“先生啊
，I comforted him.
我们有唱的。
We do sing them.
我们都这个传统啊与现代圣诗我们兼用的。
We actually mix contemporary and traditional hymns.
我们的 service 是 blended service.
It's a blend
融在一起的。
We blend everything together.
不巧今天不唱而已。
But unfortunately today we didn't sing hymns.
哇，他就大发雷霆。
So he was furious.
很可惜我没有读到刚才我讲那个例子。
Unfortunately, I couldn't say the example that I said earlier.
我早读一点，我就在说 this is the first time.
I could have said this is the first time.
你再吵我会宰了你。
One more time.
教会里面就有不同的奇奇怪怪，不唱一次歌就大发雷霆，可以把好像也把你杀掉一样的。
There are different kinds of people in the church, just like this old gentleman who got furious.
这个就是很久的一个操练，很忍的一个操练。
So we gotta train ourselves.
另外一方面
，another thing，
第二个就是说更新突破这个第一是错的，是第二大点。第一个是立足本位，第二是更新突破。
So second point is that we have to have breakthrough.
你要接受神在我们生命当中的那个开阔。
So you gotta embrace God's work of expansion in our lives.
开阔你的视野。
Be open-minded. Be expand our horizon.
开阔你的心胸。
Open up yourself. Be open-minded.
这个的腓力他本来住在耶路撒冷。
Philip, he was living in Jerusalem.
那么后来呢？神差遣他到了这个撒玛利亚城。
And then God called him out to Samaria.
神用一个特殊的环境呢，带我们都到个更高的境界。
God used a special environment to lead him to a different level, a higher level.
在撒玛利亚城呢，腓力看到更多的非犹太人。
In Samaria, Philip saw a lot of people who were non-Jews.
你知道听过三个十三亿吗
？Have you heard of the three 1.3 billion?
有人说十三亿是华民。
1.3 billion could be the Chinese population.
十三亿是回民啊，
就是说 the Muslims.
十三亿是平民
，could be the poor people.
这三个群体是全世界最大的同种同源的那个同一个文化的一个情况。
These are three of the top people groups that are of the same culture.
十三亿
1.3 billion.
十三亿回民
Chinese American.1.3 Muslims and 1.3 poor.
神开拓我们的视野。
God opened our horizon.
另外呢，腓力的人生的经历。
Another thing is that Philip's life.
神也开阔他的恩赐。
How God gave him additional gifts.
好，我回到前面一点点。
Yeah, let's rewind a little bit.
讲到神开阔我们视野的时候。
When God, when we talk about having breakthroughs and God helping us to be more open-minded.
我教会跟各位一样，你们有台语的，有国语的，也有英语的哈。
My church also has three services: Taiwanese, Mandarin, and EM.
那么我们教会是粤语跟国语跟英语哈。
Actually, we have Cantonese, Mandarin, and EM.
我们的广东堂的弟兄姊妹，他们就很怕开口讲国语。
In our Cantonese congregation, the guys were actually afraid to speak Mandarin.
那么他们面对国语堂的弟兄姐妹的时候，他们一开口先讲英语。
When they see the the brothers and sisters from the Mandarin congregation, they will actually start speaking English.
为什么这样子呢
？Why is it so？
他说：“哎呀，我怕我讲出来就是讲的不准呢。
”No, I was afraid that I would have too much accent when I speak Mandarin.
我就对他说：“谁会讲的很准的国语呢
？”But then I asked them, "Who can speak perfect Mandarin?"
你听过孙中山的国语吗
？Have you ever heard Dr. Sun Yat-sen speak?
你听过毛泽东的国语吗
？How about Chairman Mao?
你听过邓小平的国语吗
？Or this other guy?
你听过蒋中正的国语吗
？How about 张凯旋？
这是知名人士啊。 没有一个讲得准的，你怕什么？
None of them had perfect Mandarin. Why are you afraid?
我以前呢，你知道国语不是我的 heart language.
You know, Mandarin is not my native language.
国语是我装出来的。
I actually pretend.
我装的会讲一样。
I pretend that I can actually speak Mandarin.
那是学的。
I actually learned that.
我以前就很怕用国语讲道。
Before I was afraid to speak and preach in Mandarin.
我常常祷告。
I would be praying.
我说主啊，求你，求你让我讲得准一点。
God, please help me speak with less accent.
我的用字呢精准一点。
The vocabs be even better, more precise.
我的口音呢精准一点。
And then less accent.
让弟兄姊妹听的时候听得清楚，听得明白。
So people could understand me more clearly.
所以呢，我常常就为自己的国语能够准准准来祷告。
So I'll be praying for the accuracy and precision of my Mandarin.
后来我发现那是知名人士都不准。
And then I realized that a lot of celebrities actually don't even speak good Mandarin.
我不再祷告了。
So just stop praying about that.
我就为听众祷告。
I pray for the congregation.
主啊，求你让他们听我明白我讲的。
God, please help them understand me.
我已经不为自己祷告的了。
I start praying about this.
我记得以前啊。
I remember before.
我讲一堂国语，第一次、第二次的时候。
The first couple times that I preached in Mandarin.
有些人就来找我。
Some brothers will come to me.
哎，他说：“哎呀，牧师，你的国语讲得真好。
”Hey, your Mandarin is so good.
非常好。
It's excellent.
我就很高兴。
I was very happy.
后来我想一想。
And I thought about it.
来称赞我的都是广东人。
The ones who came and praised me were actually Cantonese speaking people.
还是那些不会讲国语的广东人。
They couldn't even speak Mandarin.
一直来称赞我。
They kept praising me.
我记得我去菲律宾的时候。
When I went to the Philippines.
1982年我去菲律宾。
Back in 82.
你在菲律宾的华，我在华侨教会服事。
I served at this Asian church.
No, Filipino Chinese church.
Filipino Chinese church.
他们那些弟兄姐妹都讲闽南语的。
They spoke 闽南语。
Fukinese 闽南语。
Yeah, Fukinese. Okay.
另外一种的。
Yeah.
Another kind of 傣语了。
对。
傣语了。
傣语。
可以通了，但是不完全一样。
Yeah, they could kind of understand each other, but not really.
那么我就用就学了。
So I kind of learned it.
我怎么学啊？
How did I learn it?
我用耶鲁大学出版的闽南语教科本来去学罗马字拼音。
I actually used a book from University of Yale.
Yale University 出版的那本书。
This book published by them.
教人怎么讲台语的。
To teach you how to speak the language.
是美国人写的。
Written by an American.
他用罗马字拼音教我们来学闽南语。
Using 拼音 to teach us how to speak 闽南语。
但是非常非常 accurate 的，很准。
But it was accurate.
现在我拿起我们的那个罗马字拼音的中英圣经啊，一个中文字都没有，但是我可以读。
So when I use the Bible written in, with 拼音，
我可以用罗马字拼音来读圣经。
I can actually read the Bible with
一个中文字都没有。
Without a single Chinese word,
我读得懂
I can understand it.
但是做半年的时候
after half a year,
那么我要试试用这个闽南语来讲道
I wanted to preach in 傣语
这是我的处女讲道
So this is my first sermon.
第一次讲
First time.
讲完以后，有个弟兄来到我面前
So after I was done, people came to me.
跟我握手。
Shaking my hand.
他说：“林牧师，你还是用国语吧，我们听得懂。”
Can you speak Mandarin instead, please?
我那个时候非常灰心哎。
I was very disappointed, sad.
哎呀，我以为我应该回到香港去。
Maybe I should just go back to Hong Kong.
但是我咬着牙齿。
But I persevered.
一直学下去。
I kept learning.
再学多一年半。
Another 1.5 years.
终于呢，勉强克服了。
So somewhat made it.
所以两年之后，我就开始用闽南语讲道，讲了六年。
Wow! So after 2 years, I was able to speak and preach for 6 years in Taiwanese.
现在忘记了。
But I forgot it all.
要过几日，要过几日淡薄啊。
Just a little bit.
下次你们60周年的时候。
When you have your 60th anniversary,
我那个时候91岁。
Yeah, I'll be 91 years old.
你再请我讲到，我用台语讲。
Please invite me again then, and I'll speak in Taiwanese.
若是我还在的话
，If I'm still around.
若是我还没死的话
，If I'm still alive.
我们都很怕。
We're always afraid.
我知道你们很多的外国人朋友，美国朋友。
You have a lot of American friends.
哎，我们也很怕用英语去讲道。
Sometimes we're afraid to preach.
哎呀，我的英语不好。
My English is not good.
我的英语不标准。
It's not very accurate.
这个不标准的害死我们了。
This is actually hurting us.
什么叫做标准啊？
What does it mean to be accurate?
你知道全世界十大英语国家是哪十个吗？
You know what are the top 10 countries that speak English?
就是他的国家人能够说英语的人口最多的啊。
Actually, countries with the most English speaking people.
第一个。
Number one.
美国。
United States.
第二个。印度。
India.
那么多吗？印度十二亿人口啊。
There are 1.2 billion people.
有四分之一会讲英语的已经三亿了。
1/4 the people can actually speak English.
第三个是巴基斯坦。
Pakistan.
第四个是非洲的 Nigeria, 尼日利亚。
Nigeria.
第五个是英国。
UK.
第六个是菲律宾。
Philippines.
第七是德国。
Germany.
第八的是孟加拉 ，Bangladesh.
Bangladesh.
第九是埃及。
Egypt.
第十才加拿大。
And then Canada.
说实在。
To tell the truth,
他们的英语，他们都以为自己讲得很准的。
They think they speak English perfectly, actually.
你会听印度人讲英语吗
？Have you ever heard an Indian speak English?
他都讲得很好，你听不懂而已啊。
They speak really well, you just don't understand.
他讲得很流利、很快，你听不懂而已。
They speak really fast, you just don't understand.
有什么标准不标准呢
？What has been accurate anyway?
你标准的 Oxford English 啊，这个
even Oxford English
有个人会讲牛津英语啊。跟你讲话
Speaking to you
你就会对他说什么呢
What would you say
Can you speak English please 你都听不懂耶
You wouldn't understand it
太标准的
It's too good
最标准的就是李光耀了
Oh the previous
Singapore
Singapore
premier.
Chairperson
Yeah premier yeah. 那个总理啊他的英文真是文法跟发音都是牛津英语
His English was perfect
但是你听不懂
But you still couldn't understand it.
用姐妹，所以我们不要怕。
So let's not be afraid.
没有一个什么听的准确的哈。
There's nothing that is accurate.
所以神开另外一方面，神要开阔，不但只要开阔你的视野，也要开阔你的恩赐。
Not about just expanding our horizon, but also our gifts.
说你的恩赐会扩大的。
Your gifts could also expand.
你好像腓力，他本来是做行政的。
Just like Philip, when he
后来变成传福音的。
He started from being admin to an evangelist.
后来变成跨文化的宣跨文化的宣教士。
And then becoming a missionary.
神会在我们生命不同的阶段，按照国度的需要，加添给我们不同的恩赐。
God can give us different gifts at different stages of our lives, depending on the kingdom's needs.
我的意思说，神一生当中要给你五个恩赐。我比
如说。God, let's say God gives you five different gifts in your whole life.
你刚信主的时候，你不需要这五个恩赐。
You don't need all five of them.
你只需要头一个跟两一两个哈。
You just need maybe one or two.
但是当你的灵命慢慢成熟的时候
，But as you mature,
教会有需要的时候
，When the church needs it,
国度有需要的时候
，The kingdom needs it,
神就会把其他三个恩赐给你，你知道吗
？God will release additional three gifts to you.
所以你不要那么快就封顶了啊，就停了就没有了。
Let's not cap off.
神继续的给你。神国需要的恩赐
God will continue to give you the gifts for the kingdom.
神也会把我们过去的才干啊、天赋那些 talent 啊，化为天国的天国骑兵。
Yeah, God can also give our other gifts to be weapons and weapons for the kingdom.
变成是一种武器，上帝可以使用的。
That these are weapons that God can use.
我们知道在圣经四世纪里面有个先师，一个士师，一个 judges.
There was a judge.
不是那么有名。
He wasn't that popular.
他的名字叫三家。
Shamgar.
他是做什么呢
？What did he do?
他是 cowboy.
He was a cowboy.
他是赶牛的。
He was a shepherd.
他最厉害的武器就是赶牛棍。
Yeah, his best weapon was an ox goad.
圣经告诉我们。
The Bible tells us.
他用赶牛棍一棍打死三十个腓力斯人。
He used an ox goad to kill 30 Philistines.
这个是很厉害的武器。
It was a great weapon.
这条棍呢，竟然给神来去圣化了。
This stick was actually
sanctified
by God.
分别为圣 consecrated.
Consecrated.
然后神来使用，能够成为神国的武器。
God used it to be a weapon for His kingdom.
我很喜欢音乐。
I love music.
各位，你知道一件事情啊
？Do you know one thing?
音乐不单只是说，哎呀，你唱的时候，哎，你很喜悦，很快乐。
Not only are you happy when you sing.
你知道音乐有 spiritual power.
You know there's spiritual power in music.
你这点要知道 spiritual power.
You gotta understand there's spiritual power.
所以呢，各位 praise team 的 members.
So all the worship team members,
你记得你不是一个 musician, 一个 artist 而已。
Remember, you're not just a musician or artist.
你是一个 channel of God's blessing, 神要赐福人的一个渠道，你知道吗？
Yeah.
你知道吗？你的音乐是有这种的驱魔的能力。
Your music can cast demons.
好像大卫。
Just like David, King David.
大卫弹琴的时候。
When he's playing the harp and lyre.
他以前是对牛弹琴的。
He was playing to cows and sheep.
对羊啊，对羊弹琴。
Yeah, sheep.
后来神呼召他。
But then when God called him.
他这个琴竟然可以帮助扫罗心里面那个心魔啊。
His music was able to calm Solomon, King Saul down.
所以呢，这个神正是用我们的这个天，这个神给我们 talent.
So God actually used our talent.
甚至大卫那个 sling 那个摔石的技巧呢。
And God also gave David the tool of slingshots.
能够用来打死这个哥利亚。
To kill Goliath.
这个都不是手。所谓的属灵恩赐 spiritual gifts.
These are not the normal spiritual gifts that we know about.
Non-traditional talent, 是吧？
These are traditional.
有时候我们很会注意，哎呀，我在教会好像没有什么恩赐。
Sometimes we think, hey, I don't have any gifts in the church.
也不会
讲道，也不会查经，也不会唱歌，也不会唱歌，也不会 Bible study,
也不会行政，也不会 leader,
can't do amen,
都是教会一般的 traditional 的。这种的 classical 的 gifts 对不对？
These are the classic and traditional gifts.
但是我们看见弹琴啊、赶牛棍啊、什么 sling 啊，全部都不是教会传统恩赐，是吗？
But how about playing harp or slingshot? These are not the talents that we usually associate with.
神都能够使用。
But God can use them all.
打败上帝的敌人。
Defeating God's enemy.
扩展神的国。
Expanding God's kingdom.
所以呢，神会把你过去的才干。把它 consecrate 圣化之后呢，成为天国的武器。
God can actually use the gifts that He has given you as spiritual weapons.
另外一件事情。
Another thing.
神要开阔我们的心胸。
God wants to expand our mindset.
所以第一件事开阔你的视野，哇，那么多。
First is open up your eyesight, your vision.
开阔你的恩赐，哇 ，spiritual gifts.
And next is spiritual gifts.
第三个是开阔你的心胸。
The last one,
啊，这是
你能够接纳
is your mindset.你知道一个教会的大小哈
，the size of a church
啊，不在于说这个教会多不多那个有恩赐的人。
It's not about how many talent people we have.
乃是在于说这个教会的心胸够不够大。
But more about hearts.
能够接纳跟我们不同的恩赐、不同背景的人。
How we're able to accept people from different backgrounds and different gifts.
这个教会的对这个时代的适应性啊。
How we're able to adapt to the world.
我记得有一次我去参加一个教会增长研习会。
One time I went to the conference to help churches grow.
有一个牧师做讲员。
There was a pastor who's a speaker.
我今天呢先来放一段影片给各位看一看。
Today I'm going to show you a video.
Before 我讲我的教会增长的办法。
Before how my church was able to grow.
一放出来的时候呢。
When he played the video,
我以为是放他教会的那个怎么去做教会
啊。I thought they were going to talk about how to grow the church.
他没有说，放着放李小龙出来了。
He was actually playing
Bruce Lee.
The video from Bruce Lee.
不是打，是访问了一个 interview.
It was an interview of Bruce Lee.
访问他什么呢？
What did they talk about?
那么访问他对中国功夫的那个是英语的，这来用。向老外解释什么叫中国功夫。
So they were asking him about what kung fu is.
他就拿出一瓶水出来。
So he took out a pitcher of water.
他说呢，这个瓶里面的水呢，就是中国功夫。
This is Chinese kung fu.
然后呢，他把这个水呢，就倒在一个杯子里面。
He poured it into a glass of
glass. 刚才呢是一瓶水，现在是一杯水。
It was a pitcher, now it's a glass.
水没有变，但是那个形状改变。
Water didn't change, but the shape changed.
所以呢，中国功夫就是奥妙在这里，很多变化。
This is why Chinese Kung Fu is this amazing. It adapts, changes to the environment. Why did the pastor show this video to us? He was trying to explain one point. Church is like water. In Irvine, California, US, it's just one shape. If God puts this church in a different culture,
搬回到这个的台湾南部，
say
to
the southern part of Taiwan,
罗斯你要做得成功的话，
if you want to be successful,
你就不能把二 earthen 的那个形状带回去那个地方。
You cannot use the shape that you use in earthen successfully to there.
但是教会基本的元素，彼此相爱啊，彼此学习啊，勇于传福音，这些的元素都不变的。
But the core of loving each other and spreading the gospel should not change.
但是形状就改变了。
But the shape could be different.
因为你要向台湾南部的百姓传福音。
Because you gotta be like those in southern part of Taiwan.
所以呢，就又适应了。
So you gotta be adaptive.
很多人来开始认识教会的时候
，A lot of people when they first come to church.
教会都是一平的。
Church is like.
若是稍微一变的话，啊，这个不是教会。
If it changes, this is not church anymore.
真的真的，
我大发雷霆了。
就大发雷霆了啊！
And get furious.
各位，水还是一样，都是 H2O.
But water is still the same, H2O.
形状不一样而已。
The shape is the only thing that's different.
所以今天的教会
，So today's church.
若是真的要发展的话
，If you want to expand,
他必须要明白教会的本质与教会的形状的分别。
We gotta understand the essence, the core, and the shape of the church.
并且能够与那个场景、那个 context 能够接轨。
We're able to connect the context with these.
就好像我们这里讲。
Just like what we're talking about here.
就是教会其实有不同的这个敬拜的方式。
There are different styles of worship.
有些教会的很注重研经的。
Some focus more on Bible study.
John MacArthur.
John MacArthur.
他们的教会有3000人。
3,000 people in the church.
牧师一讲到的时候
，When the pastor started talking，
你就会听见整个教会呢都打开他那个三圈的那个什么活页的那个架子。
Oh, so
binder.
Oh, so you could hear everybody open up their binders.
3,000人一起打开了。
3,000 people all opening up their binders at the same time.
那些的信徒他们去教会不单只带圣经，还带这个 free ring binder 去教会来把牧师讲的每一句话写下来。
The congregation will actually bring not only their Bibles but also the binders to write down the notes from the pastor.
因为那个牧师全世界有名的解经家嘛 ，John MacArthur 嘛。
Because he was very popular and famous for being able to analyze the Bible.
有些教会很注重这个庆贺。
Sometimes churches could be about celebration.
啊，有一唱是唱45分钟。
As they sing, they will be singing for 45 minutes.
我记得差不多30年前，我去参加这种教会的时候。
When I attended one church 30 years ago, like this.
那个牧师说，我们上个礼拜总共有250个人决志信主，请各位站起来，我们赞美上帝。
So last week, 250 people accepted Christ. Let's all stand up.
哇，大家都高兴啊。
Everybody's so excited.
哇，我前面那个老妈妈。
This older lady in the front.
我也站起来。
Everybody stood up.
就唱一唱，唱了45分钟。
And we sang for 45 minutes.
我传统教会出来的，唱两首歌我就要坐下来。
I came from traditional church, and after 2 songs, and I'm done.
妈妈不单只站，还跳哎，这样子。
She starts dancing to this older woman.
感谢赞美主，250个人信主。
Praising the Lord, 250 people accepting the Christ.
有一些的教会 celebrate 到个地步
，some churches who celebrate
还不是灵恩派耶
，they're not even charismatic.
是 Baptist church.
They could be Baptist church.
他们兴奋到那地步，有些人就倒在地上，那个不是什么。
They could be so excited. They could be on the floor too.
什么不是 sling by the Holy Spirit？ 还不是这个，就是太兴奋了。
They're just too happy.
啊，已经挡，就是挡，就是动不掉啊。
They're just gonna move anymore.
就是躺在地下了
，just lying on the floor.
那些的阿舍就把他一个一个抬出去的。
The ushers will actually carry them out.
在 Texas 有这种教会。
There are churches like this in Texas.
因为他很注重 celebration.
They're so focused on celebration.
有些教会呢很注重礼仪的。
Some are more about
ritual. 很多的礼仪好像圣公会一样。Episcopal church.
Episcopal church.
那么他们呢那个讲台哦。不在中间，还在旁边的。
Their podiums wouldn't be in the center; it would be actually on the side.
那个讲台的高度呢，好像那个喇叭一样那么高的。
It would be about that high.
所以那些弟兄姊妹的这个脖子都有问题。
So they all have neck pains.
他们高高在上的。
Because they were up there.
下面还有个螺旋的楼梯上去的。
And there would be like this staircase.
有那个，但是呢，他们读经的时候啊
，When they read the Bible，
他们呢那个读经员呢，就从上面呢走。
The person who reads the Bible will actually slowly walk down.
那么读完之后呢，他就回去了啊。
And then he will go back up.
奇怪，为什么你不在上面读呢
？So why don't you just read from the top?
为什么下来读呢
？Why would you come down here?
他说：“哎，我们做每一个动作都有意义的。
Because there's a purpose and meaning in every action.
我说什么意义啊
？What is the purpose?
读经是神的道。
Reading the Bible is God's word.
从上面下来代表道成了肉身。 住在你们中间，充充满满的恩典有真理。
Symbolizes the word becoming flesh.
Incarnation 哎，这是道成肉身的意思哎。啊，我那个时候才眼睛打开哦。
The word became flesh, and that's when I realized.
以前我不喜欢圣公会的敬拜。
Before I didn't like Episcopal Church celebrations.
现在我了解哦，原来他们每一个动作都有个意思，道成了肉身，住在我们中间哎。
Word became flesh, living among us. Now I understand more.
哎呀，有一次我去参加个教会，西雅图。
There's this other church that I visited in Seattle.
唱完诗之后
after we're done with the singing,
牧师说好，我们现在是信徒相交的时间。
No, it's time for us to socialize.
向前后左右握手。
Let's shake hands with the people around
you. 握手。
So we start shaking hands.
二十分钟都不回来。
So we're shaking hands for about 20 minutes.
还跑到外面去喝咖啡了。
They even went outside to have some coffee.
还要吃那个 Edamame beans, 那个什么豆啊。
Edamame.
哎呀，小山那么高的一个
东西。Well, a lot of desserts and edamame.
二十分钟都不回来。
20 minutes and people still didn't come back.
后来忍不住了。
I couldn't stand it anymore.
不太习惯了。
I wasn't used to it.
成何体统啊。
How is this possible? How is it right?
这个崇拜一般唱完诗走去喝咖啡。
You can go outside and drink coffee after singing worship.
还吃那个豆子，吃那么高兴，然后这样子。后来那个牧师告诉我。
And then the pastor told
me,
Pastor Lam, we're actually all very busy.
这段时间二十分钟是他们彼此相交的很宝贵的时间，因为散会之后了，有些拿孩子了，有些看孩子了，有些要吃饭，都跑光了。
This is actually a very precious time for them in the 20 minutes that they can bond, they can talk to each other.
我们弄那个小那个豆子就是一种的吸引他们留下来。
It's actually like the edamame is to attract them to stay.
他们在那边交流交通。哎呀，我这也也有好处哈。
He said, "Well, yeah, okay, maybe that's not too bad."
但是我也不敢做现在。
But I still can't do it right now.
我怕会又不回来了。
I'm afraid people wouldn't come back. The congregation would just leave and just not come back.
都有它的特色。
Every church is a little different.
甚至我们追求的路径。
Even the path we take.
有些人哎，你怎么去亲近主呢
？How do you get closer to God?
有些人在读经的时候很亲近主。
Some actually through reading the Bible.
有些人在默想的时候。默想
Some through meditation.
你知道外向的人哦
You know, for extroverts,
他们很难默想
It's hard for them to meditate.
因为他们一默想就胡思乱想
Because when they start meditating, they start thinking random things.
有些人就好像我太太就可以
Just like my wife could.
我的太太 my wife.
Like his wife.
Yeah, yeah. 她就可以
She can do that.
因为默想是好像享受主一样。
So she can actually enjoy the Lord while meditating.
我没办法。
I can't do that.
我连祷告都要开口自己听见，我才能够专心。
When I pray, I have to say my prayer out loud so I can stay focused.
我读经常有文字引导我的思想。
So I have to have the words right there.
我一面读一面默想，我不能够空空默想。
I have to read and think at the same time.
有些人在唱诗当中。
Some are praising.
我也是可以在唱诗当中。来去与主亲近
some can be close to God just by worshiping.
眼泪都掉下来
tears are streaming down.
有些在信徒相交的当中
some actually through conversing.
有些人在侍奉的行动当中
some are doing ministry.
他们与主亲近
that they can be close to God.
好，我们开阔我们的心胸。最后一个
open up our horizon. The last point.
我们要迈向万民。
We gotta go to the nations.
好像这个的腓力一样
just like Philip.
他在撒玛利亚城都很好。
He was doing fine in Samaria.
神就呼召他。
But then God called him.
这个呼召呢是超越环境常理的呼召。
It's beyond common sense. It's a calling beyond that.
一种超越环境常理的顺服。
And it's obedience beyond common sense also.
好像神叫腓力离开很成功的撒玛利亚城。
Like how God called him out of the successful ministry in Samaria. To go south to the desert place.
啊，去旷野做什么呢？
To do what?
上帝没有立刻告诉他。
God didn't specify.
但是说你先去。
But he said, go ahead.
你先去。
You go first. Even though he didn't understand.
仍然的顺从。
He was obedient.
神赐胆量向外族、向贵族去传福音。
God also gives us the courage to go outside and talk to people who are different from us.
你是否怕自己英文不好？
Are you afraid that your English is not good enough?
你是否怕自己普通话不好？
Are you afraid that your Mandarin is not good enough?
你是否怕自己的台语不好？
Or your Taiwanese not being good enough?
神要把天上各样的恩典祝福 大能大力赐给你。
God is going to give you gifts, all the power to you.
弟兄姐妹
，Brothers and sisters，
我们今天在美国
，Today we're in the U.S.
还算是活生活的比较安舒。
I think we're pretty comfortable here.
问你一个问题，谁读过一本书叫做《行在水面上》
？Who read the book？
有一位啊
，Walking on Water。
有一两有几位哈、啊？如果说你没有读的话呢？去读
If you haven't read it, go check it out.
这本书的英文名字很长、
啊。The English title is actually very long.
If you want to walk on water, you got to come up from the boat.
Oh yeah, I read it.
You did?
Yeah, the green book, right? Yeah, the green book.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
他说他也读过，谢谢你。就是中文叫《行在水面上》。
Yeah.
非常好的一本书 ，John Albert.
Great book. Yeah.
那里面有一个的见证。
There's this testimony in the book.
讲到有一个弟兄
There's this brother.
在住在DC area.
He lived in DC.
那么他叫 disciple 一个初刚信主的一位弟兄叫 Bob， 叫做随便叫 Bob。
So he was discipling this new believer Bob. Let's say Bob.
这是个人的一对一的个人的
personal one-on-one ministry discipleship
门徒训练。那有一次他们。读到一句话
One time they were reading this passage.
那么主耶稣说：“凡你们所祈求的，我就必为你们成就，赐给你。”
Whatever you ask for, I'll give it to you.
那么那个 Bob 呢就觉得这个是他说真的吗
？And Bob asked, "Is it real?"
那么这个的基督徒说：“呀，当然要看环境了。”
And the Christian said, "Depends on situation."
但是呢，神一定听我们祷告。
But God always listens to our prayers.
都是我们照主的旨意。祈求的话，他一定听。
If you pray according to his purpose, he will listen to us.
那么后来呢？这是真的吗
？Is it real?
那么他们就在那边呢，有那个就打赌了。
So they had a bet.
那么这个基督徒说
，The Christian said,
我们来试试看。
Let's try it out.
罗斯，你为一个事情祷告。
Let's pray for one thing.
罗斯在半年之内
，If in half a year,
这个事情没有什么改变
，This situation doesn't change.
没有什么动静。
No improvement.
我就给你$500。
I'll give you $500.
若是
if
有什么的变化
，if there are changes，
有什么动静的话
，or improvement，
你赔我$500好不好
？You give me $500.
好啊，好啊，好啊。
Sounds good.
那么好，你开始为想为什么先祷告
？So let's think of something to pray for.
他说我是卖保险的。
He said I sell insurance.
我的客户很足够。
I have a lot of customers.
我不需要再求什么钱啊。更舒服的是我不需
要。Yeah, I don't need to pray for more money. I'm pretty comfortable right now.
那么怎么为什么祷告呢
？So what else should we pray for?
不如我为一些有需要的人祷告。
How about we pray for people who need help?
为什么有需要的为什么人祷告呢
？Like who?
不如为非洲人祷告吧。
How about the people in Africa?
那么非洲那么大，为谁祷告呢
？But Africa is so big. Who should we pray for?
忽然间他想不如为Kenya, 肯尼亚祷告吧。
How about Kenya? Let's pray for Kenya.
那么好啊，我们就为肯尼亚来祷告。
Let's do it.
其实他不太明白肯尼亚是什么国家。
Actually, he didn't know much about Kenya.
那么就他就好，我就会开始为Kenya祷告，主啊，求你祝福祷肯尼亚。
Okay, we're going to start praying for Kenya.
叫做他们的需要供给他们等等的，为他祝福祷告。
Yeah, just praying for this country.
祷告不久之后
，After a while,
有一次这个 Bob 在吃饭的时候
，One time Bob was eating,
就遇见一个。非洲裔的女士。
He saw this African lady.
American lady.
African, right?
Yeah. 那么她在，因为你知道 DC area 人口有30%是非洲，就是非洲人，黑人嘛，哈。
Actually, there are 30% African American in DC.
所以你看到黑人是很普遍的一个事情。
So it's pretty common that you see.
那么她就以为这个女士呢是美国人哈。
And Bob thought that this lady was American.
就问他说你是从哪里来的呢
？And Bob asked her, "Where are you from?"
他说我是从肯亚来的
，She said,
"Kenya 来的。
I'm from Kenya."
哇，他吓了一跳啊
！I said, "Whoa!"
哇，肯，我就是为这个国家祷告嘛啊
！Oh, I've been praying for this country.
那么他就继续的问这个女士啊，你是什么人呢？为什么会来这里呢
？So Bob started asking her more questions about why she's here.
他是说，我是在肯亚是个孤儿院的一个负责人。
Oh, I'm actually coordinated at an orphanage in Kenya.
我在美来美国筹款了。
I came here to hopefully fund our organization.
那么就那个女生问她，为什么你对肯亚那么有兴趣
？And she asked Bob, "Why are you so interested in Kenya?"
因为我不断为你们国家祷告啊。
Oh, because I've been praying for you guys.
那么，那个女生，好啊，请你过来，不如你过来访问我们。
Oh, great. How about you come over here and talk to us?
她真的去访问。
And he actually went there.
访问回来以后
After he was done with the trip,
就发现那边的孩子很需要药物
He realized that the kids over there really needed a lot of medicine.
他就立刻写信给很多的药厂
So he wrote letters to a lot of pharmacies.
希望他们能够 write out 一些的药物呢，送到这个肯亚
To ask them to provide medication to Kenya.
结果真的有药厂的就回应哎。
And actually, these pharmaceutical companies helped them.
他总共收集了$1,000,000的药物哎。
So he actually received $1,000,000
送到那个肯亚去
medicines
啊，那个女士很高兴，就请他。
And the lady was very happy.
我们有一个 celebration， 请你过来吧。
We have a celebration. Come over.
他就去了。
And he went.
那么哇，看见那个他们就很高兴，还介绍说，这位先生帮助我们 fundraising 一百万美元的药物。
So they're saying this is Bob. He helped us get $1,000,000 worth of medicine.
当天肯亚总统也去了。
That day, the president of Kenya actually showed up too.
这个总统觉得很奇怪，平凡的一个美国人，竟然做一个那么好心的事情。
And the president was very surprised. Why is this American doing this?
啊，都很热情的招待他。
So like treated him really well.
还给他个 half day tour.
It gave him half day tour.
总统陪他去玩一下。
President touring with.
在玩的时候。
So as they were touring.
他看见一个 building.
He saw this building.
他说这个什么地方
？What is this building?
总统说这个是我们用来囚那些政治犯。
Oh, this is where we keep all the political criminals.
那么美国没有政治犯的，对吧
？There are no political criminals in the U.S.
那么他说，那么就什么叫做政治犯呢
？So what does it mean to be political prisoners?
他说不同意我的都在里面去。
If you don't agree with me, then you go in there.
他说他冲口而出啊。
So he said this.
因为美国不能接受这个事情。
As American, couldn't really stand.
他冲口而出。
So he burst out.
他说总统先生。
Mr. President,
你不应该这样子做的。
You shouldn't be doing this.
你不应该把这些反对的人放在那个地方去的。
You shouldn't keep those people who oppose you in
the prison. 那个总统很惊讶，你什么人跟我说这句话？这样。
Who are you to be saying this to me?
后来就没事了，就回去。
And then he went back.
过了几个月之后。
After a few months,
有一天。
One day.
这个 Bob 的电话响了。
Bob's phone rang.
美国国务院打给他。
This is 国务院。
State Department.
State Department from the U.S. called him.
他说你是 Bob 吗
？Bob
啊，他说我是，什么事情
？Yep, it's me.
他说我是美国国务院打来的。
I'm from the government.
你最近是不是去过一趟肯亚
？Did you go to Kenya lately?
他说我是啊。
He said, Yep.
你对总统肯亚总统讲过什么话
？What did you tell the president of Kenya?
我没有讲什么话。
I didn't say much.
他都不记得讲过什么话。
He didn't remember what he said.
他说肯亚总统打电话给美国，打给国务院。
He said the Kenya president called him.
就是说，我们已经肯亚已经释放了一批的政治犯。
He said we released a bunch of political prisoners.
他说这些政治犯，我们美国总统，我们美国政府逼他放的很多年，他都不肯放的。
The U.S. government asked him to release these people for many, many years, but he wouldn't do it.
肯亚政府说是因为 Bob。我们才把这个政治犯释放。
But then Kenya said it's actually because of Bob that we released these prisoners.
后来呢，这个美国这个肯亚总统
，So this Kenyan president
还在请这个 Bob 再到肯亚
，invited Bob over to Kenya.
他说我要选拔一些的内阁，请你过来跟我一起祷告。
I need to pray with us for some cabinet members.
一个平凡的人。
Just a normal person.
只是做一些很平凡的事情。
Normal things he does.
竟然产生那么大的果效。
Having this much impact.
影响到穷人。
Affecting so many people.
甚至影响到政府。
Impacting government.
这是圣经所说的王的心啊，都在神的手中，好像浓够的水一样。
This is like the king's heart is in the Lord's hands.
用的当这个 Bob 愿意的时候。
When Bob was willing.
那么一个那么平凡的人。
A normal person.
能够做不平凡的事情。
Doing amazing things.
我最近去高雄参加一个会。
Lately, I went to 高雄 in Taiwan.
这个会的主题是什么呢
？The title of the event was
平凡的人做不平凡的事情。
Normal people doing amazing things.
我们都是平凡的人。
We're all normal people.
但是我们可以为主做不平凡的事。
But we can do amazing things for the Lord.
弟兄姐妹
brothers and sisters.
这是我们今天神给我们的一个的 challenge.
This is a challenge from God this morning.
我们今天希望不要在这个我们好像没有什么事情做了。
We don't want to be like, there's nothing else to do.
哎，我要搞好我的花园。
I'm just take care of my garden.
一直做植物啊，就做。
And just making sure the plants are fine.
最后变成植物人了。
And then become a, veg.
有些人哎呀，我安安乐乐就死了，变成安乐死了。
Some just wanna peacefully die.
有些人说哎呀，最近怎么样啊？
Said,
哎呀，我手忙脚乱啊。
Oh man, I've been really tired.
我度日如年啊。
Every day is like a year.
啊，什么意思呢？
What does it mean?
手忙就是一天都打牌啊，忙啊，脚乱啊，跳舞啊，打牌跳舞，手忙脚乱。
Very busy playing 麻将。
啊，我度日如年啊，过每一天都是 party， 好像过年一样的度日如年啊。
Every day is like a party.
这样子我们的 life 就这样子慢慢的耗尽。
And that's how we spend our lives.
弟兄姐妹，你这件事情。
Brothers and sisters,
我说过了
one thing,
我们今天不需要经过白色大宝座的审判。
I've said it many times that we don't have to go to the throne to have judgment.
The great white throne.
Great white throne for judgment.
因为耶稣已经为我承担我所有的罪孽，我感谢赞美主。
Because Jesus already took all the burdens and sins for me.
但是我们有第二个审判。
But there is a second judgment.
就是说神会问你。你怎么样使用我给你的恩赐？
God is going to ask you, how are you using the gifts I've given you?
你怎么样使用我给你的生命？
How are you using the life that I've given you?
你怎么样使用我给你的身体？
How do you use the body that I've given you?
你是想办法满足这个身体呢？
Are you trying to satisfy yourself?
遵行神的旨意？
Or using your body to serve God's purpose?
人活着不是单靠食物。
Men do not live on bread alone.
乃是靠神口里所出的一切话。
On the words of God.
好像我们到最后的时候看到今天。
So、at the end, we want to do missionary work. But these are things that we got to do. Number one, be a player. You commit yourself to either short term or long term missions. Or be a prayer to pray for others.
You got to pay.
Third one, you got to pay.
Pay, pray, play, pray, pay.
Play, pray, and pay.
就是我们今天面对宣教的工作。
This is how we should deal with missionary work.
求主帮助我们。今天我们看见教会荒凉。
Today we see that the church is in a dire state.
好像大卫倒塌的帐幕一样。
Just like David's tent that was broken.
也好像那个祭坛已经受毁坏一样。
Just like the altar being broken also.
今天神要复兴教会。
Today God wants to revive the church.
重新把大卫的帐幕建起。
From the ground up, we're going to build it up again.
再次修理。这个毁坏的祭坛
fixing the broken altar.
我们请赞美队
Let's have the worship team come up.
再唱我们昨天晚上唱那首诗歌，献身为活祭。